Hey everybody, Josh with True Craft Barbecue, Uni Ambassador and Steak Fanatic, and today I am taking two of my favorite brands and gonna show you how to make the best steak using my Innova Precision Cooker and using my Uni Pizza Oven. You may be wondering, why? Well, look at the steak I will be cooking tonight. It's really thick. If I were to try to do this more traditionally, it's gonna be very hard to cook this thing to a nice perfect temperature throughout. When I put it in the Innova Precision Cooker, that thing is within 0.1 degree of accuracy. And you may be thinking, well, that seems like a bit of overkill, but the difference between rare and medium rare is only 3 degrees. So by putting it in the sous vide, I'm gonna make sure that this entire steak is the exact same temp from top to bottom, put it out onto my Uni, Grizzler plate, sear it off using that really, really nice heat coming in off the top and to get a nice caramelized crust on top. The kicker is I'm not just cooking one steak, I'm cooking two. This is a little bit thinner, but when it goes in the sous vide, they're both gonna cook at the exact same temperature. And when they finish off, I'll have two steaks varying in weights and thickness cooked to perfection. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm gonna show you my steps to make the perfect steak using the Innova Precision Cooker and the Uni Pizza Oven. I'm Josh with True Craft Barbecue. Let's go cook. To get the party started, first thing you do is take your steak or steaks, put them on a wire rack, apply a lot of salt. Don't go easy on it. You can apply a lot at this stage. It's not gonna hurt it. Hit it on both sides with kosher salt. Put it in the wire rack inside of your fridge for at least 2 hours. Make sure you get your water bath going about 30 minutes before that first 2 hour timer is done. Set your Innova Precision Cooker to 130 degrees Fahrenheit. Once the steak is done dry brining, bag it up, vacuum seal it, drop it inside the Innova Precision Cooker's water bath, and let it go for 3 hours. 30 minutes before your 3 hour timer is done, go outside, get your Uni preheated. I'm gonna get it going high, drop in my Grizzler plate, let it go for the next 25 to 30 minutes to get scorching hot and ready to sear off our steaks. It's been about 25 minutes, my timer just went off, so I'm gonna take the steaks out of the bags, pat them dry with paper towel, that's important. Don't worry about seasoning, and remember, the Uni gets super hot and we don't want that top-down broiler-like heat to burn any of the seasonings. So we're gonna hit it with seasoning right when they come out. Pull the Grizzler plate out, put the steaks in, but don't move them at this point. However you lay them in there, just make sure they're gonna fit. Put the steaks into the Grizzler, put it back into the Uni, set a timer for 2 minutes. 2 minutes is done, here we go. Look at the steak, make sure that you have really nice color developed on one side. Remember, we're not trying to cook these steaks. They've already been cooked to 130 degrees from top to bottom because of the Innova Precision Cooker. All we're looking to do is to get a really nice developed crust on the outside. Set your timer for 2 more minutes, put it back in the oven. As soon as the steaks are done to your liking, take them out, let them rest on a clean cutting board. Here's what we're gonna do. Go get your favorite steak rub, hit it liberally with it, and let it rest. After about 5 minutes, we're gonna cut into this bad boy. The 5 minute rest is done, so it's time to cut open and see what we've done with it. The Innova Precision Cooker did it perfectly from top to bottom, and the high temperature heat coming from the Uni Pizza Oven in combination with the Grizzler plate made an outstanding savory crust on the exterior of it. That's it, I am hungry, it is dinner time, but I wanted to let you know if you wanna get creative and combine the awesome power of your Innova Precision Cooker and your Uni Pizza Oven, find me on Instagram at TrueCraftBarbecue and let me know what you're planning on experimenting with. Thanks for watching, have a great time. For me, it's chow time. See you later.